శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వర రావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ 2008 లో స్థాపించిన కళాశాలలో ఎంబీఏ నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్ మరియు ఐఎస్ఓ సర్టిఫికేషన్ సాధించిన మొట్టమొదటి కళాశాల శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ త్వరలో ఆటోనమస్ కాబోతుంది.
2014 లో ఐఎస్ఓ గుర్తింపు, 2015 లో రాష్ట్ర ప్రభుత్వంచే ఏ గ్రేడ్, 2016 లో నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్. ఇప్పుడు ఎంబీఏ సాధించిన సంస్థ శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వరరావు కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ.
Good morning to all. In the last class we discussed about the transistors, NPN transistors and PNP transistors and the configurations. Configurations are CB configuration, CE and CC. Okay, CB is over, common base configuration. And also transistor current components. What are the current components? IPE, INE, IPC. Pole current, electron current. Okay, and IPC and reverse saturation current and reverse collector saturation current. And also we discussed current parameters, emitter efficiency and transport factor beta and large signal current gain alpha. Okay, today we will discuss about the CE configurations and punch through effect and reach through effect, early effect and common emitter configuration. Okay, first of all CB input characteristics. CB means base is common to both input and output. Base of the transistor is common to both input and output circuits. This is the common base configuration. Okay, this is the input characteristics. VI also known as the VI characteristics. CB VI input characteristics. X axis denote the voltage and Y axis denote the current. Current in milliamperes, voltage is in volts. VEB versus IE characteristics, where VCB is constant. Okay, this is the curve. It is the curve between an input voltage VCE, VCB. First of all, this is the circuit diagram, common base configuration VEB. That means voltage across the emitter base voltage. This is the emitter voltage and this is the base voltage. This voltage is the emitter base voltage. Okay, and input current is emitter current. This is the input. Input voltage is VBE and input current is IE current. And constant collector base voltage and this voltage output is constant. Okay, so it is the curve. An input voltage VEB, that means emitter base voltage, and input current IE, that means emitter current at a constant collector base voltage VCB. Okay, the emitter current is taken along X axis, Y axis. Emitter current is taken, so this current, emitter current is taken along Y axis and emitter base voltage along X axis. Voltage is taken in X axis, current is taken in Y axis. This is the curve, input characteristics of the transistor in CB configuration. From the characteristics, we observe the following important points. The input resistance is the ratio of change in emitter base voltage. Okay, change in emitter base voltage, that means delta VBE. Change indicates delta emitter base voltage to the resulting change in emitter current, that means delta IE at a constant collector base voltage VCB. Okay, it is the input resistance is the ratio of change in voltage to current. This voltage emitted by voltage, that means input voltage, to the resulting change in input current, that means emitter current, that is the delta IE at a constant collector base voltage VCB. So resistance equal to voltage by current, that means RI equal to delta VE by delta IE at constant VCB, that is equal to the constant. After the cut-in voltage, this is the cut-in voltage. Okay, this indicates the cut-in voltage. Cut-in voltage is also known as the barrier voltage, barrier potential. In silicon, cut-in voltage is 0.7 volts and germanium is 0.3 volts. The emitter current IE increases rapidly with a small increase in emitter base voltage VBE. Thus, the input resistance is very small. The emitter current IE increases rapidly. Current is increases rapidly. The small increase in emitter base voltage. Small voltage means cut-in voltage. After cut-in voltage, current is rapidly increases. So, resistance is voltage by current. Voltage is small. Small by high. That means input resistance is very, very small. So, it can be observed, there is a slight increase in emitter current IE with the increase in VCB. This is due to change in the width of the depletion region in the base region under the reverse biased condition. VCB means this voltage. VCB voltage is positive for NPN transistors and it is negative for PNP transistors. VCB is positive for NPN transistors and it's negative for PNP transistors. On the other hand, VEB, that means this voltage, input voltage, is negative for NPN transistors and it's positive for PNP transistors. Okay, this is the input characteristics. So, this is input characteristic, input in the x-axis, this is the voltage, y-axis is given to current. Okay, small increase in voltage, after cut-in voltage, current is rapidly increases. So, VCB is positive for NPN transistors and it's negative for NPN transistors. Vice versa, VEB is the vice versa. VEB is negative for NPN transistors and it's positive for PNP transistors. And next one, output characteristics. This is the output characteristics. CB, common base output characteristics. First of all, output voltage and output current. We have to find out output voltage and output current. Okay. It is the curve between collector current IC. Output current is IC. This is the IC current and collector base voltage VCB at constant emitter current IE. Emitter current is input current. Output voltage and output current is taken but constant input current. Okay, it is the curve between collector current, that means output current is IC, and collector base voltage, that means output voltage, that is the VCB at constant input current. Input current means emitter current, that is the IE current. Okay, the collector current is taken along y-axis. So this is the y-axis. Collector current is IC is in milliamperes, and collector base voltage along the x-axis. This is the x-axis. We have taken collector base voltage. Okay, so this, the transistor is in common base configuration. The output characteristics has three basic regions. What are they? Active region, this is the active region, and saturation region and cutoff region. This is the cutoff region. The active region, saturation region and cutoff region. Okay. Emitter of the transistor is common to both input and output circuits, and hence, first active region. This is the active region. But the operation in the active region means emitter base junction is forward biased. That means emitter base junction is JE is forward biased and collector base junction JC is reverse biased. Okay, in this region, transistor act as an amplifier. So in this region, collector current, that means IC, is approximately equal to the IE, that means emitter current, and transistor works as an amplifier. In the active region, the collector current is essentially IC, essentially is almost constant. So curve is taken like this. The dynamic output resistance is the ratio of voltage to current. So change in collector base voltage delta VCB to the resulting change in collector current delta IC at a constant emitter current IE. Okay. So R naught equal to VCB, that means output voltage by input output current, VC by IC per constant IE input current. The collector current IC is almost independent on common base voltage VCB, and the transistor can be said to work as a constant current source. That is important point. The collector current IC is almost independent on VCB. IC is almost independent on VCB, that means constant. And the transistor is said to be constant current source. This provides very high dynamic output resistance. Okay, that is the active region. And next one, saturation region. Saturation region means both are forward biased. So input emitter base junction JE and collector base junction JC both are forward biased. Okay, here the IC is independent of the IE. IC is independent of the IE. IC decreases rapidly as VCB becomes more negative. That is the saturation region. That means saturation region means emitter base junction and collector base junction both are forward biased. IC is independent of the IC. So this IC is independent of the IC. So this is a constant. So approximately IC is independent of the IE. IC decreases. In this IC decreases rapidly, VCB becomes more negative. That is the second quadrant. And next one, cutoff region. Cutoff region means both are reverse biased. So the region below the curve, IE equal to 0. That means this curve, IE equal to 0, is known as the cutoff region, where the collector current is nearly 0 and the collector base JC and emitter base JE junctions of the transistors are reverse biased. Okay. And next, DC current gain, alpha equal to IC by IE. Alpha equal to IC by IE. IC means collector current by emitter current, where IC and IE are the values of the collector current and emitter current at any point on the curve. And last one, AC current gain, that means alpha DC, that means delta IC by delta IE per VCB is constant. This is the input and output characteristics of the CB configuration. Okay. And next one, early effect. This is very early effect and comes through effect. These two are very important in the examination point of view, where reverse bias voltage VCB increases. Suppose reverse bias voltage VCB increases, so the width of the depletion region is also increases automatically, reduces the electrical base width. That means depletion region is reduces. This effect is called the early effect or base width modulation. Once again repeat this. When reverse bias voltage VCB increases, the width of the depletion region is also increases, which reduces the electrical base width. This effect is called the early effect or base width modulation. So this decrease in the base width has two consequences. These two are: there is less chance for recombination within the base region. Okay, hence the transport factor beta and alpha increase with an increase in magnitude of the collector junction voltage. Okay, and the charge gradient is increased within the base, and consequently the current of the minority carriers injected across the junction increases. This increase emitter current slightly, increases the emitter current slightly. These two consequences of the early effect. Okay, the charge gradient is increased within the base, and the current of the minority carriers injected across the junction also increases. Okay, next one, punch through effect. This is the punch through effect. That means in the active region, the collector base junction is reverse biased. Okay, for every transistor there is a limit on the maximum value for this reverse bias voltage. In the active region, emitter base junction is forward biased and collector base junction is reverse biased. Okay, so collector base junction is reverse biased. For every transistor there is a limit on the maximum value for this reverse bias voltage. Okay, collector base junction is reverse biased. This reverse bias voltage must be within the maximum safe limits specified by the manufacturer. Okay, if this maximum limit is exceeded, maximum limit is exceeded, the transistor breakdown occurs. The curves shown at the right side of the dotted lines, that is VCB maximum, that is the VCB maximum is extended, represent the, this is the breakdown condition. When collector to base voltage increases, width of the depletion region at the junction increases. Therefore, when VCB increases above the VC maximum, increases in the depletion region in such that it penetrates into the base until it makes the contact with the common base depletion region. The condition is called the punch through or reach through effect. Okay, when this situation occurs, breakdown occurs. That means large current flows which destroy the transistor. To avoid this punch through effect, VCB should always be kept below the maximum safe limit specified by the manufacturer. That is the punch through effect. Okay, so CB configuration is over, and next one, CE configuration. That means common emitter configuration. So emitter is common between input and output. In this configuration, input is applied between the base and emitter, and output is taken from the collector and emitter. Okay. The emitter of the transistor is common to both input and output circuits, and hence name common emitter configuration. The input voltage in the CE configuration is the base emitter voltage, and the output voltage is the collector emitter voltage VCE. The input current is IB and the output current is IC current. Okay, and current relations, these are the current relations. So IC equal to IB into alpha DC by 1 minus alpha DC plus IC B naught by 1 minus alpha DC. So beta equal to transport factor beta equal to IC by IB. Okay. So IE equal to already we known, IE equal to IC plus IB. That means IB equal to IE minus IC. So beta equal to IC by IB. IB mean IB equal to IE minus IC. So substituted IE minus IC. So beta equal to divided by IE. Numerator and denominator divided by IE. So IC by IE by IE by IE minus IC by IE. That is equal to beta equal to alpha. IC by IE means alpha. So alpha by 1 minus alpha. Okay. Alpha equal to IC by IB plus IC. And divided by numerator and denominator by IB. So alpha equal to IC by IB by IB by IB plus IC by IB. So that is equal to alpha equal to beta by 1 plus beta. Okay. So beta equal to IC by IB. Alpha beta equal to alpha by 1 minus alpha. Alpha equal to beta by 1 plus beta. Okay, these two equations are very very important for the problems. And the input characteristics of the CE configuration, these two are the input characteristics. It is the curve between input voltage VBE, it is VBE and IB. IB is the input current. IB means base current at a constant collector emitter voltage VCE. The base current is taken along the y axis and emitter base voltage VBE is along x axis. Okay. The input resistance is the ratio of resistance is the ratio of voltage by current. That means ratio of change in base emitter voltage delta VBE to the resulting change in the base current delta IB at a constant collector emitter voltage VCE. That is given by RI equal to voltage by current. That means delta VBE by delta IB at the constant output voltage. That means VCE is constant. Okay. The value of RI, that means internal resistance in CE configuration, is greater than the value of RI in CB configuration. As the input to the transistor in the CE configuration is between the base to emitter junction, and the CE input characteristics resembles a family of forward bias diode curves. After the cut-in voltage, this is the cut-in voltage. Silicon is 0.7 volts. The remaining is the 0.3 volts. Okay. Cut-in voltage the base current IB increases. The base current IB increases rapidly with a small increase in voltage. So, which voltage? Base emitter voltage. Thus, the dynamic input resistance is small in CE configuration. Okay. For a fixed value of VBE, IB is decreases as VCE is increased. The voltages VBE and VCE are positive for NPN transistors and they are negative for PNP transistors. Okay. Input characteristics. So, voltage is increases, some smaller value cut in voltage. So, current is rapidly increases. And next one, output characteristics. Okay. So, this characteristics shows the relation between the collector current IC and the collector voltage VC. These two are the output current and the voltages. The IC versus VCE. For a various fixed values of the IB. IB means input current, base current. This characteristics is often called the collector characteristics. The value of beta DC of the transistor can be found at any point on the characteristics. Okay, by taking the ratio IC to IB at that point, that is beta equal to IC by IB. This is known as the DC beta for the transistor. And from the output characteristics, we can see that change in collector emitter voltage delta VCE causes the little change in the collector current delta IC for a constant base current IB. Okay, thus the output dynamic resistance is high in CE configuration, that is R not equal to resistance R not equal to delta VCE by delta IC, output voltage by output current at a constant IB. The output characteristics of common emitter configuration consists of three regions, that are active region and saturation region and cutoff region. Active region means for the operation in the active region, the base emitter junction JE is forward biased and while collector base junction JC is reverse biased. The collector current rise more sharply with increase in VCE in the linear region of the output characteristics of the CE transistor, that is the active region, and saturation region. Saturation region means both are forward biased, that means the base emitter junction JE and the collector base junction JC both are forward biased. In this region, IC does not depend upon the input current IB. The saturation values of VCE designed to VCE saturation usually ranges between the 0.1 to 0.3 volts. This is the saturation region. And next, cutoff region. This is the cutoff region. Cutoff region means both are reverse biased. So, in this region, below IB equal to 0 is the cutoff region of operation for the transistor. In this region, both the junctions of the transistors are reverse biased. So, for saturation, IB is greater than IC by beta DC. For the active region, VCE is greater than VCE. DC current gain, beta equal to IC by IB. AC current gain, so beta AC equal to delta IC by delta IB with the constant VCE equal to constant. VCE constant, beta AC equal to delta IC by delta IB, constant VCE. So, that is the common emitter configuration. Okay.